crowd in this stadium and up into the commentary box. Well, I put myself on the chopping block and say, I thought Samoa were the ones this tournament, this weekend. I got it wrong last weekend, but they're playing so well. But Gaston Revolt will be trying to stop them.
Mornay Ferreira, our referee in charge of this one. And here's Marcos Mineta, the real firepower. Creates something out of nothing for Argentina. Former World Rugby Sevens Player of the Year. First semi-final, Argentina against Samoa, and off the boot of Gaston Revol, the great Argentine player, we are underway. There's a big collision of bodies in the air, and that is really well brought down under enormous pressure from Samoa. They get to play first, and already scooting away, getting rid of a couple of very soft tackles in defence. Tunatui Tama from the kickoff, strikes for Samoa straight away.
It's Tuitua time and time again. What a way to start. Absolute melee off the kickoff. Two pods, plus Ithgro going up there. They tied it up and off he goes. Round Gonzalez, through Gaston Revol. Just decided he was going to score a try. No one was going to get in the way of it. Tuitama.
Barely got hands on him. What a start for Samoa. And Tunatui Tama, conversion is going to be good too. 7 points to nil in the opening minute.
Such a threat for them, isn't he? Dangerous runner, big physical guy, knows how to break tackles.
Argentina rocked early.
Sides here, but their first cup semi in six tourneys.
They went all right the last time out, though, didn't they? Ended up winning the tournament overall. Mineta bangs that back, and it'll be there for Revolt. It's awkward for Mineta. It's that little almost trademark dart down a blind zone. Now here's the powerhouse. He screw up through the middle. So hard to put down. Gets up and goes again. Argentina getting into their work now. Cleverly batted on for Gonzalez. And now Argentina pouring forward. Gonzalez, speaking of powerhouses, barrel his way through a couple and earning a penalty.
Well, I thought he'd isolated himself. I thought perhaps there were two guys outside him. I mean, you'd never knock back Gonzalez to make the contact area a win for him, but I thought we could have shifted it. And as it is, Samoa infringing. Slick, great awareness. That defender's almost coming from behind him, but he just feels him, flicks it on.
Interesting to note that Argentina's captain, Matias Osatsuk, starting on the bench. He took a knock in the quarter final as Palandini goes into some big contact. Now shifting across Mineta. He doesn't need a lot of room nor a second invitation. Comes back for Revol. Now Herman Schultz. These tireless work causes in the Argentina line. And yeah, brilliant work. Apelo Malico got hands on that one to earn the ball back for Samoa. They get on with things, but oh, the stitch up pass, big shot coming in. Revol hacked this ahead, and it'll be advantage over, is it, for the knock on. Palandini has stayed down after that heavy contact. There's some big shots coming in the opening couple of minutes. He's all over the place. Eventually it's Nui Lavia who goes to ground. Samoa working from deep inside their own 22, looking for this big, big wide ball. Gonzalez awake to the threat at the moment of Balbasa Afasua. Argentina just cutting off the options for Samoa at the moment is now Palandini, who's picked himself up and tries to put a shot on two. Revol's going to be the one coming across. He's not going to get close to Tuitama, who just had it. Brief thought of, do I go? Yes. Can't get past the escrow, though, and nor can they collect on the way through. It would have been spectacular not to be, and Palandini comes back to tidy up for Argentina, who now they could. Oh, I was going to say bust out. Afasua.
midfield. Alpha Sur still looks fresh, but can't say that for the rest of the boys out there. What a passage of play. Suratama throws a bit of a loose one out the back. Letofia couldn't gather, couldn't scoop it. And then Argentina had the opportunity to go in broken field. Interesting to see if that had gone to hand for Gonzalez. What would have happened? Great bit of defence there in the middle of that passage from Ithgrow. 1v1 against Tuatama. Used the touchline brilliantly.
Crouch!
Gandini to feed the scrum for Argentina. It's
set.
Very little between these teams, as you would expect of such high quality sides in a semi-final. Here's Hermann Schultz just clinging on to that ball and carving off a few extra metres. Ithgrow working with Revol down low. Hands right out in front. Ball is good from Vetterfeld, and there's a clever little flick from Ithgrow for Mineta. Gets rid of one, and this might be where Accelerate chip kicked over the top. You can see it coming. Regathered, Marcus Mineta. Tackle just made by Malik, or had to be made. Still there for Argentina. And now Gonzalez, he's got Schultz with him. Won't need him. And Luciano Gonzalez strikes off a brilliant bit of work from Marcus Mineta.
That is Argentina at their best. All their superstars showing what they're about. Ithgrow, first up, the little flick out the back. Mineta running his way back around to space, sees the 1v1, takes the chip on, regathers, launches it, a bit of a Hail Mary, but then the hands to get it out to Gonzalez. And what a man to get it to.
Some level of skill. The Argentine blondes having more fun. They'll also probably find out it's really expensive too, but enjoy it while you can. They can't quite even it up. 7-5.
You're putting yourself in that category as well, Ricky. You having fun?
Always having fun. Argentine fans.
And how badly these Argentinian players would love to kiss the trophy
in front
today.
They've made a mistake on this kickoff though. Player in front of the kicker. That's a coach killer, those kind of ones.
I was still too excited from the try to watch, and maybe they were too. You're absolutely right, they've got to find your discipline in these games. As much as it's about the fight and the scrap and the effort, so much of it's about accuracy. Key moment now, less than 30 seconds to go. When the scores are this close, sometimes a score before the half. Really influential.
Big scrum here on halfway for Samoa. And away they scoot with Scanlon. Ducks under one tackle. Gonzalez tracking across. Now it's Samoa's turn to kick ahead. Gonzalez should be able to get back there in time. Oh, has Apelo Maliko bore down on him. Mineta now, as Argentina look to break away, shake to kick. Instead gives the ball for Ithgrow, who gets rid of one, keeps it in play, just has gone back in Samoan hands though. It's Letofia who tidies up. Argentina are going to be really stretched here. Gonzalez is going to be the one sweeping across New La Vea. Blue shirts coming everywhere, and Samoa are the ones to score. After the halftime hooter, banging it down, Farfoy Falanico.
Nico with the prize at the end of it all. What about this? Scanlon going up against a bigger man. Ithgrow staying in but throwing the loose one. Eventually found its way to Nueva Valera. I thought, what a 1v1 we've got here, him and Gonzalez. But he didn't need to take him on in the end. Falanico tracking that support line, massive in the game of sevens. Stamps it down.
Really glad that went emphatically into the turf. That try scoring, and it puts Samoa in front at halftime in the semi-final. They lead Argentina 14-5. taking on Fiji at the moment, though. It is Samoa leading Argentina 14-5. Samoa scoring just before halftime to get this little handy buffer. And as the second half gets underway, we can go straight down and have a chat to Argentina's coach, Santiago Gomez-Corta. Santi, thanks for your time. As always, what was the message to your team at halftime?
Hello, it's a pleasure to talk with you. The message is try to keep the possession and try to be calm. Don't start to move the ball without any sense. So the idea is try to keep the possession and see what's happening, who you want to find that space.
Hey, Santi, it's Tom Mitchell. How do you feel in these big games? Do you feel calm?
Yes, it's more hard for me, the qualification. The pool are always very tough, and here is see what's happened, and always we want to be better every game, but the first day, the qualification is more hard than this one.
Now, these are always the fun ones. Usually when we have you on the mic, Santi, there might be a try, but we'll let you go on this one as you're going to get a penalty anyway. Thanks again.
Thank you very much, and I hope we can score right now in less than 2 minutes.
That'll be nice for you, I'm sure.
Thank you.
Well, it's so great to get to chat to Santi in such a tense situation. But I guess it's a thing too, like you've done the hard work on day one and kind of enjoy it, could you? I don't know.
There's got to be a little bit of it at this stage for him that he knows his team is there or thereabouts. And you know, I think they'll be pleased where they are on the standings. Yes, they want to keep pushing on, but they set out this season. Gaston Revol's telling me that they were already thinking they're going to have to qualify for the Olympics through South America. So the fact that it's looking like they're going to get auto qualification this year, not confirmed yet, work to do, but they'll be pleased with that.
I tell you, when we were in Dubai watching the Football World Cup, and these Argentine guys every night would be down with us riding every moment of Argentina, I think they would have been happy with a Football World Cup win, let alone the effort they're going to here. They've lost control of that one. The message from Brian Limar at halftime. Thank you to our translator, Ruby Tui Alusoo, which is hard and direct from Samoa, which is kind of their way.
Yeah, that's what I thought you said as well.
Penalty the other way here though, so quick tap for Argentina. Lovely ball floated over the top, and Ethgrul, with all the calm and patience, puts it down for an important strike, although they're going to check.
Checking for you now, Morning.
Well, we've seen a few recent games. On second look, haven't counted. This one looks pretty all right to me.
Morning, I have a decision.
Yep.
You may award the try.
Try will be awarded. Hit back try from Rodrigo Ethgrul. How good has this man been all season?
It's a good score under pressure. What a pass. Pelandini, as he gets hit, gets rid of that ball, the missed pass. Here it comes. Boom. Over the top. Milico can't get there. Big score in the context of this game.
Conversion's no good anyway. I think it timed out regardless, did it? 14-10. Samoa leading. No, he got it. Did he? Did he get that kick?
Well,
he
it
did.
Went over, hit the crossbar and skidded over. That will count.
14-12. There's a bit going on here, and speaking of going on, way goes Va'apelu Maliko. Moneta chasing, race to the line between the two flyers, and it's Apelu Maliko.
What an athlete this guy is. What a rugby player. What a quality exponent of the game of rugby sevens. Just takes off, skips out of that diving tackle, the first attempt. So strong, and Minetto does his best, but he can't get there, and he gets the look. Whoa.
That's kind of like, I feel like that's from one try scorer to another. Apelu Maliko in the face of Marcos Minetto, and putting Samoa 19-12, and there he is, 36 tries for the season. Minetto not too far behind him on 32.
Maybe a little bit of that contest coming out onto the field.
Over to you, Marcos. Plays 12 now. Argentina have had to hit back a couple of times. Samoa really have been the dominant team, but Argentina won all of their semi-finals so far this season. It's off the back of work by a couple of these guys. Esperup, Moneta going to throw a big wide ball here. It was really risky. And it's scooped up by Pauletti Slater. It was such an ambitious pass from Argentina. And it gives more ball to Samoa. Oh, Nui Lavea, though, running out of room here. Bit of a wasted chance for Samoa.
He's been good, Nui Lavea, but getting it wrong there. It's nail-biting stuff here in Singapore.
Little mates looking tense. His team have got the lead at the moment.
Pelo Milikos feeling himself. You can just see after that score, he's trying to create stuff for his team. I've got to say, I don't know how kindly I would have taken it if I was chasing back and someone done that to me. But what would I have done, to be honest?
Probably just store it in the memory banks, I'm sure.
Giving him a stern talking to.
Sternly worded.
Someone.
Intimidating stare down. Calandini, important throw for Argentina. Got to get back into this. They have to be the next to strike if they are to go through to another cup final. There is Calandini on the wraparound. Again, just big collision. Battle of wills in the middle. Argentina down on numbers. Some guys putting in some very big shifts in this match. And now looking to create a little bit of space. No way through for Elizalde. Shifts away for Santi Alvarez. And now Palandini again. Here's Gonzalez trying to steam away. Slap, slap, slap it to Itama. Holding him at bay. Still holding him at bay. Still going, Gonzalez. Eventually dumped to the ground on the 5 meter line. Samoa pour in. Massive contact. And the penalty will go Samoa's way.
Off his feet playing the ball. Number three.
That's big. It's a big moment in this game. So close. Gonzalez, unstoppable. What a tussle with Tuatama. Get these two going at it. Get off, get off. And look at this. Coming up. Takes a couple of them out.
Come off. Number eight.
Oh no! The agony.
So
these
close.
Kids are riding every moment this weekend. 19-12, Samoa lead. Argentina need a big play, ticking into about the final minute. Or is it Samoa on their way to the cup final for the first time since December?
Seeing that wide shot, Schultz very slowly coming off, kind of sums up the effort these boys have put in.
Samoa secure possession from the line-out. Upetai does well, and they get a penalty too. So soak up a little time here, and they're going to kick for the corner.
Alvarez infringing there. He's had a tough weekend. He broke his nose, I think, this week after breaking it last week in Hong Kong. Got a couple of black eyes to show for his time. Nervous moments for these boys. They know that he can win these tight moments, but they haven't got the ball here.
What a star of the game he was, and what a fabulous coach he is. Looking nervous and tense at the moment.
Telling them to compete in this line out.
Oh, they're going to get ball here. Not straight from the line out throw. So Argentina will need to go 65 odd meters and a converted try. And they are a team that can do it.
Last chance saloon for the boys from Argentina. Who's going to step up? Superstars across the park. It only needs one.
Marcos Moneta is on the bench.
Fine.
Luciano Gonzalez is standing out here wide on the right. Final play for Argentina to try and send us to extra time, perhaps. A little bit of footwork, and now Rodrigo Isco, he's another game breaker. Floating a lovely ball, or just the bounce for Gonzalez. Had to hold it up. Shots coming on. Keeping the ball alive, though, Argentina. Palandini this time. Not making any ground as Samoa pile in, desperate to get their hands on the ball, can't do so. Escrow again will come back into the traffic, get rid of a couple as he got himself a little isolated there. No, ball spills back again for Santiago Vetterfeld. And now some space coming down this left side, stopped in his tracks.
Graziano.
They've carved off meters here, Argentina, pressing for a try. They're on, says Tom Mitchell. Luciano Gonzalez, he's got Alvarez with him. Santi Alvarez has to come back and field up the middle. And now it's Escrow. Escrow for the line. Escrow, is he over? No, not quite. Is it there this time? Alisalde. He's claiming it. It's a stretch out. The post, the ball, the bodies, everything in the way.
What have we got here?
Stand by, Mane.
Try or no try. Ball on the line in front of the posts.
There's paint on that ball. Hoppetai trying to stop it. Getting
Mane,
everything
have a decision.
Behind
yeah. You may award the try.
Try given. What an effort from Tomas Alisalde, and now a conversion in front to send us into extra time in the semi-final. Let's play on. Argentina and Samoa at the end of regulation time in the first semi-final. So Samoa have won the toss. They have chosen to receive. Argentina will get the kickoff. What's the what do you reckon? Is there a better option?
Oh, you go with whatever the trend's been over the tournament. Probably. I think I'm normally up to kickoff. See what Santi's saying. What about the leaders in this group? Like?
Mucho su territorio, mucho su territorio y con control. Se van a equivocar eso.
Paciencia, ataque o defensa, lo que sea, tranquilo. Al palo, pero tranquilo.
He calls himself the grandfather of the team, and if ever you wanted a calming influence, it was it right there, Gaston Revolt.
What a bit of wisdom from the older statesman.
Samoa's extra time form is good, and won all three. Including against Argentina just last week.
Yeah.
It's golden point, first score wins.
These are the moments in your career that you savour. They're nerve-wracking. They're anxiety-producing.
Tensions all around the ground. Mineta's back on, so he was on the bench for that last passage of play. Fresh legs, here we go, extra time. First score wins, Argentina and Samoa. And it's, you're going to go out on the full. So a mistake on the kick from Argentina will give Samoa right attacking possession.
Possession huge in extra time. Escrow, look at that. In the end, it's in vain, but what athleticism. Great hops from the big man. About everyone doing their job now. Someone want to put their hand up eventually, but everyone's got to do their job.
Find.
final at stake. Away come Samoa in their vibrant blue, getting rid of Wanoa Niue and then handing the ball back to Mineta. Chance here now for Argentina, ball bobbling all over the shop. Yep. Alandini, who's going to scoop it up? Anyone? Oh. Nobody. Who wants it? First knock on is going to go against Samoa, so it'll be Argentina's feet to the scrum. Oh, much happening in this extra time.
Oh, it's a bit of this and that. Nobody wants it. Normally, so much emphasis on holding on to the ball in extra time.
I guess there's that urge to, for the one big play, right, to win it, get it done.
Another fatigue plays in as well. It's huge at this stage. These guys have played so much rugby, an intense level.
Mineta feeds the scrum and he's going to